Okay, welcome to today's iPad painting tutorial. On this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to paint a moonlit landscape. We're going to do a starry sky, and we're going to do some mountains and some really low-lying mist and maybe low-lying clouds as well. So I'm using the app Procreate. And in terms of the tools and brushes and things that I'm going to be using, I've opened an A4 canvas. I'm going to be using, if I go to the airbrushing brushes, I'm going to be using predominantly the soft brush and maybe the medium brush in parts as well. There are some smaller versions of those airbrushes, but I'm going for the bigger ones in this selection. And I've got some pre-selected colours that I'm using here. And these colours have codes, and if you put in the codes into the hexadecimal section here, press enter, you can start to piece them together into your own colour palette. But there is a link in the description as well as the colour codes. You can download the free file from our Patreon page. So the first thing I'm going to do on my first layer is go to my colours. I'm going to pick this first colour. Now it's almost black, but it isn't quite. Very close to black, and we're going to drag it into the canvas and it's going to fill the screen. So now that I fill the background, I'm going to create another layer and I'm going to add some stars to that layer. So I'm going to use this white color. I'm going to stick to the soft airbrush, but I'm going to turn the brush down, not to the lowest size, but pretty low, maybe put it at the top end of 1% there. And instead of tapping crazy like this, where you'll end up with squiggles instead of actual dots, I'm just going to start applying them quite carefully. So I'll just undo those and I put my fingers at the end of the pencil and just start to apply them a little bit more controlled. Have them randomly spaced out. If you put them too uniform, they're going to look artificial. So I'm pressing on lightly for some of them. Some of them are pressing on a bit more, so you get more of a random look. Now, I've used this technique in some of my other tutorials, so you might be familiar with this technique. It's a really good way of just getting a starry sky without having to draw every single star. So allow some of them to cluster, almost touch. Again, we want to preserve that real randomness. So if they're too evenly spaced out, they're not going to look random enough. Then what we can do, once you've got a healthy amount, is that you can duplicate. Then we can go onto our transform tool and we can flip it horizontally, maybe vertically as well, and we can just move it somewhere else on our canvas. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose to put it next to it like that. Then I'm going to go to my layers and I'm going to pinch them together to condense them. I'm going to repeat the process. So I'm going to duplicate that layer, go into my transform tool, flip it horizontally and vertically, and then I can start to piece it together down here as well. I'm going to go back to my layers, pinch them together, duplicate again, go to my transform tool, horizontal and vertical, just to mix them up so it doesn't look too obviously a repeating pattern. I'm just going to go down to my bottom corner now, like that. Again, I'm going to pinch the two layers together, a little bit awkward that, but it is possible, and duplicate that layer, transform, flip, horizontally and vertically. That's not worked actually. Yep, that's better. Now, if at this stage you're starting to notice almost a pattern emerge, then you might want to go into certain areas with an eraser and just do what you can to eliminate any sense that there's maybe a pattern, because you will get a concentration of repeating forms in the middle or somewhere else. And if you want to just random it up a little bit more, you can use the eraser, go in layer like that. Again, I'm going to pinch the two layers together. I think this time I'm going to reduce the size. I'm going to do it so it fills a quarter of my scene there. I'm going to duplicate it, transform. I'm going to move it across like that. Okay, so I'm going to just merge those two layers again, but I don't need to do any more. I can at this point, if I want to, decide to just turn the opacity down a little bit. It might be that they're just shouting a little bit too much, so I'm going to reduce the opacity of them. So we're going to create another layer. We're going to put it underneath the stars. I'm going to choose the second color along of my colors. On my soft brush, I'm going to have the brush quite big now, so I'm going to set up to maybe like 12% and keep it on 100% opacity. And I'm just going to introduce this color across the scene. I'm going to avoid the corners because I want almost this color to be fading off into a real dark area towards the corner. I need to be careful not to overdo it as well. It is on 100% opacity, but I am pressing on lightly. I can press on more and you're really going to overdo it. So I'm pressing on lightly as I want to fade it out, and I'm pressing on a little bit more towards the center area. If you're not happy with the way it looks, you can always go to your adjustments, go to your Gaussian blur, affect the whole layer and slide it across, and it will soft focus it or will blur it out, so that if you've not done a great job of having it transition gradually, then that's going to help that process. So I've created another layer. I'm still on my soft airbrush. I'm going to have the brush still at 12%, but I've turned the opacity down to around 50%. And I've now selected this third color along. And I'm going to think about where I want my moon to be in my landscape. And I'm thinking somewhere in this region. So I'll do an area here where I imagine the moon's going to go. We'll keep it quite sizable. And then I'm also going to extend that color across where the horizon is going to be as well. So I'm only pressing on lightly. I could press on a lot more, and it's just a bit too much. So I'm only pressing on lightly. The effect that I'm looking to create is soft, which is why I'm using the soft brush. So pressing on lightly with the Apple Pencil is going to be a better effect as well. Again, we'll go to the adjustments, go down to the Gaussian blur, onto the layer, blur it across a bit more. We'll take it to around 40, 50% kind of works. And then I think I'll stay on the same layer and I'll repeat the process a little bit with the same color. So I want to build up the luminosity of this area and extend that across the horizon line a little bit too. I'm gonna go over a bit more in that center area. I think I probably achieved as much as I can with this color in that area. I don't think I can keep pressing on and it's fully saturated in that area now, but it's not in the other areas. So I want to continue the process of it blending off. And again, go to my Gaussian blur. I want to affect the whole layer and just blur it a little bit, perhaps not as much as I did before. So maybe only like 25% this time. Okay, now I'm going to choose another layer. Still underneath the stars. I will start to put some of these above the stars eventually, but for now, I'm just going to keep the stars at the top and then I can move them later if necessary. So I'm gonna go to the fourth color along. Stay on the same settings, except I might just reduce the size of the brush to 10% this time. And I'm going to begin with where I imagine the moon is going to be, somewhere in this area. Starting just to lightly start to fade it out. So pressing ever so lightly around the edge of that. I can press on more for the center area, not a problem. And I'm really pressing lightly as it moves out. And I'm going to extend that lightest color now across my horizon line. We'll go to my Gaussian blur, the whole layer, and blur it out. This time again to around the 50%. I'm going to go back in and I'm going to keep on trying to affect the area immediately below where the moon is going to be. And I can extend that across a little bit too, again. Go back to my Gaussian blur, blur it up to about 25% again. I'm going to create another layer. But this time, I think I might put this new layer on top. So we'll get a bit of a mixture now. So whenever it gets to this real light color, which we're using at the end, now it's going to start to eliminate some of those stars a little bit. It's getting so bright that we're losing the sense of the stars now. So I'm just gonna undo that, reduce the size of the brush a little bit more to about 8%, and the opacity down quite drastically to about 25%. So I am going to add a bit more light to where the moon is gonna go. I'm especially wanting to focus my saturation of color down towards this horizon line more. We'll take it pretty much all the way across. Again, we'll go to our Gaussian blur. I'm not gonna do this quite as much as I did before. We're gonna take it just a bit, so around the 20%. We move along our colors to the last color, and this is the real brightest color now. And we're gonna use that on perhaps another layer. Let's keep them separate. And we're going to apply this lightest color with the same settings, so we're still on the 8% size and we're still on the 25% opacity. And I'm really going to add some of this light color at the bottom area where the moon is going to be, and I can also extend it across here a little bit as well. Go to our adjustments, Gaussian blur, a whole layer, and let's blur it out. Okay, so before I do the landscape and the actual mountainous areas, I think that I need to create a moon. So we'll do this on a separate layer. We'll go to our brightest colors, which are down here. We'll go to the area that we want our circle to be, and I'm going to just reduce the size of the brush to top end of 1%, and I'm going to draw a circle in like that. If I hold the pencil down, it's created a obviously not a perfect circle, but it's got the option here to edit the shape and turn it into a circle. Now, if you're not happy with the size of it, you can just drag it from somewhere, not the dots, because that will start to turn it into an ellipse again. So you want to keep it as a circle, drag it from somewhere on the line, and you can move it to wherever you want it to be. So I want it to be somewhere in this area. Just need to make sure that the size is about right. When I'm happy with it, click out of the circle, and now I can start to use that shape and fill it in with that white color. So what I just did, because I've created a line that is an enclosed shape, now I can drag that color into the shape. Initially it flooded the whole area, but what you can do is when you've dragged it across, is you can turn the fill and the flooding of the area up and down on the slider. And that's perfect. Now, because the line and the shape that I filled in now really a bit too sharp, I'm going to go to my Gaussian blur onto the layer. I'm just going to slide it across and you'll see the two will kind of merge a little bit better. And that's perhaps a little bit extreme. Something like that works quite well. I'm going to go back and add some detail to the moon, but for now, I'm going to leave that as it is. I think now that I've created my moon, I'm going to create another layer that goes underneath it, but it's above all the other layers. And I just really want to make this bright area of the horizon just pop out a little bit more. So I'm going to go to my lightest color here, turn the size of the brush to around 8%, keep the opacity a bit lower this time at 30%. And I'm just going to send that color, that bright color, across maybe a double line. Go to my adjustments, my Gaussian blur to the whole layer, and just blur it across like that. Maybe a bit more, in fact. It's around 30%. Now I'm going to create another layer. And on this layer, I'm going to go to my second set of colors and I'm going to use the first color along here. It should be a little bit darker than the color I've just created. And that is going to be my distant set of mountain range. So it is on a new layer. The brush I'm going to use is still the soft brush. I'm going to turn it to about 2% and keep it on 100% opacity. So I just want to really describe the shape that I want in the distance. So I'm not going to get anything too tall. It's just going to be tall enough just to stand out. And just like we did before, I can now drag that color into that area. Now it's going to seem really bright at first, but we're going to start darkening it up again in a minute too. Now when you zoom in, you may notice there's a slight line there. If that's the case, you can always try it again and just slide it that way a little bit and you can see that line starts to disappear. I just ran out of screen space, so I'll drag it onto that corner and keep dragging it along to the point where it's as good as we can get it. Now I can always tidy that up if I need to a little later on, that isn't a problem. But we'll keep going, we'll create another layer. We'll go to our second color along and we'll use the same 2% size on the brush. We'll probably reduce the opacity to around 60%. And I'm just going to create a second set of rises and mountains across here. Again, we can drag and fill that, slide it backwards, slide it forwards until it finds the right spot. Again, I'm not too worried about the fact that it has almost created two layers there. We can change that. That's not really a problem. Now, I did want it that lighter color. So what I need to do now is go to my opacity within the layer settings and just turn it down a little bit, and that's perfect. I'm going to stick on the same color, but this time I'm going to turn the opacity up, but I will create another layer again. And this time I'm going to perhaps just have some more shapes that cut in and out of that area. Try and find something that works for you so you're happy with it. I want to see some of these two tones poking through, but we can start to create some areas perhaps that do rise above. And again, we can fill, we'll create another layer. Go back to our colors, go to the third color along this time. Same brush settings, except I'm going to leave it at 100% for this set. And we're going to start introducing some mountains now, some hills that really interfere with everything else that we've got. We'll create one here and maybe one in this area too. Again, drag it in, go to our darker color again, go to our layers, create another layer. Same brush settings, bring it across. Drag the color, go to our last color along, create a new layer. And then this time we're going to have the nearest features. They're going to be the darkest and you can really determine what you want here. Drag it in. Now you've got the overall feel of the landscape now, but if you're not happy with any of those layers, then you can just determine which layer that you want to work on. And you can just go in and fine tune the shape of your mountain range. So I'm going to start with the distant one. All you need to do to really affect this properly is press and hold. It has selected that color, and if I've got my brush quite small, I can go in, I can really fine tune, polish up some of the details, add some little elements to it if I feel that it's going to make it more realistic. It is behind everything else, so you don't have to worry about going over anything. That's not going to interfere with anything else. Again, move along your layers, find the next layer you're working on, select it, go to the color, press and hold, and now we can fix some of these little issues that were appearing. Again, go back through my layer, find the layer I'm working on now, press and hold on that layer, zoom in a little bit, create something that you like the shape of a little bit better, create some more bumps, make it look a little bit more real. Go back up a layer. Now, it is also possible to use your eraser, obviously, at this point. So if you're not entirely happy, pick a type of eraser that you want. Doesn't really matter. I've got an airbrush as there again. I've got it on 100% opacity. Now, just pick a size of the brush. So I can just start to remove bits of this if I feel like I've gone too far in areas. You may accidentally reveal things that you've not quite done tidily, so just be aware of that. Again, if you've got any of these little anomalies that have appeared, then you can go back to your brush, select the color, and just remove some of those little strange things that created that when we were doing fill. Likewise, if you start to notice it on the previous layers, go and select the color, just remove it. You can fine tune this. I'm not too bothered really. I'm only really after creating the overall effect. So as long as we achieve that, then that's great. We'll keep moving up our layers. So we've got that really dark color now. So I'm going to press and select that dark color. And I'm just going to use that to create some slightly more interesting shapes now, because it is more foreground. So you're going to see perhaps more of the bumps are going to be more interesting features. It'll be slightly more unusual. As you get closer, you'll start to see more bumps that stick out a little bit more. They flatten off as you get further away, but as they get closer, you start to see some of the character a little bit more, perhaps. I might remove some of that, actually. I'm going to go up a layer on this real top layer now. Not entirely happy with some of that, so I might remove some of this. Again, I can add more features as well, obviously. So there is an area here that I'm not very happy with, so I feel like I want to add another feature here. So the way that I'm going to tackle this is I'm going to go to the nearest layer, which I think the most suitable one would be this. I'm going to press and hold on that color, but I'm going to create another layer. And I'm going to go to my brushes. I'm going to leave it at the 2%, but I'm going to turn the opacity down this time to around 60%. So it's going to have something of that color, but I can now go in and I create another feature area, but it's going to be a little bit lighter than that one there. So I can just add another layer of interest. I can do this at any particular region and add just a little bit more. And I think that area works a bit better now. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my colours. I'm going to pick this lightest colour and I'm going to keep it on the soft airbrush, but I'm going to put it up to around 3%. But I'm going to, in fact, I'll put it up even higher to around 4%. We're going to turn the opacity down really low at about 5%. And I'm going to carefully work through my layers. So the first layer is that one there. I'll go onto it and I'm just going to add some of this lighter colour at the bottom part of that layer, just a hint of it. Don't need to do very much at all for that top section. And all I'm trying to do, if I zoom in, is you see it's lighter now at the bottom part of that mountain range than it is at the top. And I'm going to do all the layers in exactly the same way. So I'm going to work up my layers and I'm going to go zoomed in and I'm just going to apply it at the bottom area of that. And you'll notice every time I'm applying this, because it's underneath the next mountain range, the only area it's going to affect is the bit of the layer that's showing through underneath. So I can really just start to bring out a highlight at the bottom of that little bit of land without affecting anything else, which is great. I go up a layer to this one. I can apply, perhaps in more circular motions now, a sense of maybe fluffy cloud, have it a bit more broken, so it looks a bit more believable, like low-lying mist. Perhaps a little bit up there as well. We're not on that layer yet, so we need to go up a layer. Add a little bit of it in here. Perhaps be selective at certain points. Maybe you just get a little hint of it coming through here, but you don't want to take it too high up anymore. Just a little bit of it over here, but not too much. If you wanted to add any more, maybe turn the opacity really even lower. Turn the size of the brush up a little bit and just have a slight sense of wisps coming through. So it's breaking up a little bit as it rises. Go back up to that next layer. Work in, and it's only this little section here, isn't it, in fact? So we can work some of that in. Work some of it into the here. Oh, we've got a bit of an anomaly now because it added that layer before, and actually it should have been down there. That works better now. So it should have been in front of that one, but behind that one. So it's in the correct place now. And now it's going to enable me to carry on working as I was, and it will work better. That's any problem with layers, is that sometimes you will get a little bit confused, but it is part of the process. It does help in the long run, but it can just confuse you here and there. So do your best to keep the layers logically ordered. It's going to help. So I'm going to keep the light coming whenever we've got an area underneath the moon especially. And then we've got our last layer. I'm going to turn the size of the brush up, and the opacity is going to be put down to around 2%. There's not going to be much of the light shining through. Now you can really see that I've got a problem with the edge of that. I'll come back and fix that in a minute. But I'm just having just some of that because it's actually in shadow from some of these areas here. I think what I'd like to do, in fact, is create a bit of a break. So I'm having an area of this mist going in front, and perhaps an area here, which pushes this section back, which is going to bring another section forward. I think that will work. And again, we'll just add a little bit more of this low-lying mist for these sections here. And I think I would like to add another layer on top of that. Go back to my colours. I'm using this dark colour. Turn the size of the brush down again and the opacity up to full. And I'm just going to use that now to bring in a really close area. And just to, again, close some of this down again. And then we can do the fill thing. Now, I'm not happy with the edge of that. You can only see it now because I started to put a highlight colour next to it. So I just need to go back to that layer to fix up the edge. Make sure I've selected the right colour. It should be on the black. So I'm just going to tidy up some of the details here. In fact, maybe a better way to do it would be with a smudge tool. So if I go to a medium brush on the smudge tool, and I can just go along the edge and just, instead of redrawing it, which is going to mess up some of the misted areas, I can just use the smudge tool to tidy it up, push it around, and we get a different effect that way. If I want to just continue to create this as a more forward piece, I could turn the opacity down on my brush and I could just bring this section forward a little bit. Need to be careful now because I don't want to destroy that low-lying mist effect. Maybe want to shut down some of that a little bit, so I'm just getting rid of some of the light that's there. I want to perhaps keep it a little bit brighter here. So how can I make it brighter there? Well, I could at this point just start to work carefully over the top. So I can select that colour, turn the size of the brush down, and it almost doesn't matter now because with the fine tuning, you can just really get in amongst it now. Perhaps turn the opacity down a little bit, but you can really get in and amongst the details and start to add by hand some of the real light areas that you want to be prominent, to stand out better. Maybe there's a section here that just picks up some more highlights from the moon. Okay, I might come back to some of these details, but I do really need to start working on the moon now. Now, it helps if you have a reference for the moon, but it doesn't need to be 100% perfect, as long as it gets the general effect. You might want to zoom in a little bit, keep the opacity fairly low, put it maybe at around 20%. We're on this second colour, which is a great colour for using turn the size of the brush down. We're still on the soft airbrush. Put it around the 1%. And if you've got a reference for the moon, you can just start to generally put in the kind of colours, or the shapes rather, and some of the blotches that you would see on the actual moon surface. Maybe swap and change between the colours. What you could also do perhaps is just go into the edge of your moon, go onto your soft airbrush, just reduce the size of the brush down and turn the opacity of the eraser down, and just perhaps just sharpen up the edge a little bit, because if you remember when we drew the circle and then filled it in, it really did create almost like two bands. So you've got almost like a two brighter halo. So I'm just going to just rub it back a little bit just to help create a real sharp edge. Now you have to be careful at this point, because you can end up just sort of rubbing too much out. So I'm just turning the canvas, just gradually trying to reduce some of that halo effect. A little bit is fine. I'm just reducing it back a little bit. And then I'm going to go to the layer and I'm going to duplicate it, and it's just going to really make it a little bit brighter. So I'm going to merge those two layers together. One thing you could experiment also with this is if you go into your adjustments, go to bloom, affect the whole layer, and perhaps just turn it up. You might find that it really blows it out a bit too much, but maybe just a touch in that direction is going to work and create the right level for you. You can see it's very easy to go too much. When we've got nothing, perhaps it seems a little bit dull. Turn it up. Maybe just 2% perhaps even. We could compare it to nothing, put it up to the 2% region, or nothing. Yeah, so maybe just a touch of it is actually beneficial. So I'll put it around 2.2%. That seems to be working pretty well. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go through some of the layers, tidy them up just a little bit, still on my soft airbrush, turned it up to 100%. I'm just going to perhaps just add more of a suggestion in the very foreground that there's actually some trees. They're even in this nearer section, still quite far off, so I don't need to draw each and every individual tree. But maybe you'll notice just a bit more texture, a few more spikes sticking up. Go to our next layer. Again, select the colour that's nearest. You don't need to go back to your colour palette all the time. You can just grab the colours from the area. Tidy up any edges if you're not happy with the way it's looking. Create some more little bumps. Not very happy with this area. I'm going to reduce some of this mist down so it's a little bit lower. Maybe just sharpen up that edge a little bit. Go back up a layer to this layer, and I think if I grab that colour, I'd like to make more of these features again, because I feel like they're getting a little bit lost. Turn the opacity down though and just make them stick forward a little bit more. Just fine tuning at this point. You know, once you've created the overall effect, there's nothing wrong with going back into it and just using your judgment and your eye to just bring out some of the features and not live with the thing that's kind of almost created itself. So yes, you've used some techniques to get you to this stage, but then you can use your judgment and go back in and just further bring out extra details just by eye. Go back down my layers, pick the colour, come to this layer and I'm going to select that color, and I'm just going to use that to bring out a couple of more textures in there, because it does look quite flat in that area, which I'm not entirely happy with. So I'm just going to bring out a little bit more of the details. If I feel like I can't quite do that with that color, I can also select a slightly darker color here, and then I can add another couple of almost features that are just maybe sticking out a little bit more prominently from that region. So they're not quite as dark as this, but they're not quite the same as that either. So experiment a little bit with the opacity. Bring some maybe of some of the lighter colors from the background and start to create another sense of layers also. So you don't have to use the darker colors, you can also use the lighter color. So you can send things further back and bring things further forward, obviously. Create the odd highlight. Feel like, again, I just noticed maybe a section here where it needs a little bit more of the bright colors coming in. Maybe keep it quite wispy. Keep it a bit more textured. Okay, I'm going to leave this tutorial here at this point. I hope you've enjoyed watching. I hope you've had some success if you decide to follow along. You might find that the colours look slightly different on yours than they do on camera. That's just the fact that I'm using a camera, and sometimes the camera doesn't quite pick up the colours that are actually within the colour palettes that I'm using. They just look slightly more vibrant, more blue, or whatever. But do check out the link for my Patreon page that has the free colour swatches anyway. Make sure to subscribe, check out my other tutorials, I do lots of landscape tutorials. Please support the channel by giving this video a thumbs up. Leave a comment for the kind of things that you'd like to see in future tutorials. And thanks very much for watching, I'll catch you back here soon. See you later.